been walking in a field at Primley, I got some facts that I would like to share about stinging species. So, lots of different species of insects have warning colours that warn predators that they use unhappy meals because of their stings or other defences. So let's say that two hypothetical stinging species, let's say bees and wasps with different colour patterns, both had stings. A predator would have to try lots of individuals of each to know that both of those colours equal unhappy meals. But if both of those species had the same coloration, a lot fewer of their individuals would be eaten because the predator will mistake them for the same species. So that's why bees and wasps normally converge on the same colour pattern. But then, that's when cheetahs creep into the system, and not the wildcat. Flies and moths, over evolutionary time, adapt the same colour patterns onto them, so that predators will mistake them for bees and wasps. And even though they don't have stings, just looking like an animal that does provides pretty much the same protection. But there are subtle differences between them that can help you distinguish one from the other. Bees and wasps have elbow-shaped antennae and six legs, but not always stripes. Some bees and wasps even have blue and purple patterns. But there's a difference. Bees usually have fur on them, while wasps are mainly bold. Now for the flies and the moths. So flies, they've got massive eyes that act like goggles, which give them an almost stereotype vision. But moths, they've got softer wings that are a lot larger, and they've got fluffy antennae. So they're the differences between the stinging species of bees and wasps and the non-stinging species of cheetahs, flies and moths.